Welcome, welcome again, cricket fans, to the Clean Bowl Cricket Channel, where we aim to discuss everything West Indies cricket, past, current, and future. In this episode, we will deviate from our current events of late and focus on five cricketers who served the West Indies with aplomb during the 1980s and beyond, or if you will, during the 20th century. Five cricketers, specifically five effective bowlers. Now, before we proceed, we would like to ask that you please do hit the like and subscribe buttons. Again, please do hit the like and subscribe buttons. Now, back to our content. As we mentioned, we are featuring and honoring five players, specifically bowlers, who served the West Indies without much what I call acclaim or glory of the heralded bowlers at that time. The fast bowlers who terrorized international cricket. These players went rather under the radar, comparatively under the radar, if you will, for West Indies cricket, even after their playing career. So the Clean Bowl Channel feels that it's only right to give some honor to these players. We'll start off by honoring Keith Boyce of Barbados. That's right, Keith Boyce of Barbados. Keith Boyce played Test cricket for the West Indies, and he was very effective as a bowler, specifically. Keith Boyce plied his trade for Barbados and also for Essex of the English County League. Keith Boyce took 60 wickets in 21 Test matches for the West Indies. So again, Keith Boyce makes our list and is worthy of acclaim. The next player on our list is Wayne Daniel. Wayne Daniel also hails out of Barbados. He was a muscular, fast bowler. It was mentioned that he terrorized the England team in 1976, but he lost favor after joining World Series cricket. But again, Wayne Daniels, like Keith Boyce, was a very effective bowler for the West Indies. He took 36 wickets in 10 test matches, and that indeed was a very good accomplishment. Next on our list is Van Burn Holder. That's right. Van Burn Holder, as Keith Boyce and Wayne Daniels, hails out of Barbados. He was a fast medium bowler, and he took a total of 109 wickets in 40 test matches. That's right, 109 wickets in 40 test matches. Next on our list, we have David Holford. Yet again, another Bajan who served West Indies cricket with aplomb and honor during the late 1980s. Holford was a very effective all-arounder. He was a handy lower order batsman, and he contributed well and served West Indies cricket well. Holford, in the 1966 second test at Lord's, saved the match by adding 274 for the sixth wicket with Gary Sobers, his cousin. Holford was effective in his own right. And in 24 test matches, Holford averaged 22.58 runs. So David Holford, our fourth Barbadian on the list. Folks, rounding off our list is none other than Norbert Phillip. That's right, Norbert Phillip, who hailed out of Dominica. Norbert Phillip was also an all-arounder who batted well and served the West Indies cricket well. He plied his trade in the English Premier League. He was an all-arounder and was especially effective at the domestic level. Norbert Phillip took 21 wickets at 17.7 runs and scored 230 runs at 76.6 that was his legendary, if you will, and most effective year, 1976-1977, for the combined islands. He also served West Indies cricket well as an all-rounder. So five cricketers. There you have it, folks. Keith Boyce, Wayne Daniel, Van Benholder, David Holford, and Norbert Phillip. Effective cricketers in their own rights. Talented cricketers in their own rights, who played at a time when West Indies cricket was overloaded with star power. But we have to give honor unto whom honor is due. And if we don't honor our contributors, our excellent contributors of the past, and keep their names alive, who will? So thank you again, folks, for tuning in. Hope you enjoy this episode.